right, new assignment. This time we're building up the complexity even more. We've got our cube, we've got a sphere, but we've also got a cylinder. And so start out by getting the tracing paper or whatever you call that, the model, I suppose, out, and then a new sheet of nice fresh canvas. And we do the same tracing. I'm still using the same sheet of charcoal paper. Something that I found is that the charcoal paper actually works better when you've used it a few times already, because the first time you use charcoal paper, the line is super dark. And that's okay, except for, let's say, if you're trying to paint something that is extreme light, then that really dark edge can show through the paint. You'd have to layer it a lot to get rid of that. So I actually kind of like having old charcoal paper to use when I'm tracing. And you have to make sure you use a nice sharp pencil and that you tape the edges down really correctly. And all of the techniques that Kevin teaches in his videos about how to do the tracing correctly. Tape it down very firmly and then trace it with a sharp pencil. Make sure all of your lines are there. When you peel the upper paper away, don't just rip it all off all at once, but peel it off carefully to make sure you haven't left anything behind. I have forgotten to trace a few lines several times over the course of these various assignments, and so I learned my lesson. Oh, here I'm experimenting with an actual pencil because I tried using mechanical pencils before and they were okay, and then I tried a real pencil and I realized it doesn't really make much of a difference. Okay, and then we lay down the base colors as usual, like we did before, and then I think I must have forgotten or lost some of my videos because we're jumping right here to the finished product. The only thing about this picture that I'm a little bit dissatisfied with is that edge, that cylinder edge that blends into the table, looks a little weird. The sphere, could do better gradients, and then also the cylinder top could use a little bit of a line to make it look less two-dimensional and more like it's an actual cylinder with a rim. So that's a critique that I have myself. But anyways, as if you want to learn more about this process, what I was thinking, etc., etc., you can check out the blog at bit.ly/skyart, SCYART, and I'll see you in the next one.